It's Casey Brown TV Show. Good morning, good afternoon, good evening to my beautiful people. It's another beautiful day that God has given to us. That's why we're here again. So if it's the first time, please start to subscribe and leave your hand on the notification bell for more videos and updates. So I think I'll drop a video, you'll be first person to be notified so you can come around and grab your information. Here we talk about migrants and document issue. You want to know more about your documents, more about how to prepare yourself for commission, a P. I'm here to give you information about that. You can hit me on my WhatsApp number. I'm here for you. So let's talk about this in Nigeria, because people want me to be talking about this in Nigeria. If they drop new updates, what are they saying about it? If there's a possibility for them to pass the law, if there is any good information, let me be dropping it for them. Yes, the Minister of Agriculture just tweeted on her Twitter. She said that she needed to pass the law. Then she needed the Parliament to pass the law. Eternal Agricultural Minister of Agriculture has warned that crop collections are at risk. The migrants need to be able to work in a legal manner, or the mafia will step in and grab huge profits. See, you understand? Italy Agricultural Minister Teresa Bananova has warned that the crop collection are at risk and the migrants need to be able to work in a legal manner, or the mafia will step in and grab huge profits. If they don't pass this law, the mafias will go carry these irregular migrants, go their farm, go work with them. They will pay this small money, and the money they're supposed to pay for taxes, they will put it in their pockets. How the economy will really grow? Eh? She was addressing the Senate last days. She was saying that these irregular migrants, they will use them to work and they will underpay them. And with the place where they live, it will be a better place. And they work for the mercy of those criminals because they are irregular, because they don't have documents. You can't see anything, because if you don't want to work on your own, understand? So she's saying now, okay, we have migrants who want to work. Why can't we pass the law so we can use them to work? She said they are crying that they need almost 270,000 migrants or 350 migrants to work in the field, in the farm system right now. Because now is the harvest time, they need workers. If they didn't put this law, the mafias will benefit from it. They will be taking these people to work with them and pay them less money and use them anyhow, and they won't pay taxes. How the economy could grow? How would the economy grow like that? So Italy is now considering measures that will legalize foreign workers, not only in farm, but possible also to include home workers. In other year, Italy is not considering measures that will legalize foreign workers, not only farms, but possible also to include home workers. You see? So we need to be prayerful. Unions have spoken out in favor. Stressing that this would bring economic and social benefits. You see, if they pass this law, there is benefit in the social and the economic profit. Because when they employ almost 300,000 or 250 migrants to work, they will be paying taxes, paying contributions. Understand? Because they are legal, because they have passed the law. But if they don't pass this law, they will still use this irregular migrant to work in their feed sectors, and all the money will be on their pocket. So that's why she's saying she don't want that corruption. She wanted to pass this law so that everybody will benefit, the migrants and the farmers, and the government, the economic also. Understand? Because these migrants have been working for long. They have been working for long. They have been in Italy, been working for long, but they are irregular. So they are there, but now they are crying for farmers, because they are using those farmers, those migrants that used to come from foreign countries to work because they are legal, they have documents, but they mix them with irregular migrants. But now when there is shutdown, now these mafias will benefit, because now they're going to use this irregular migrant to work in the field without paying taxes, without legal contracts, because they don't have documents for them to write contracts. So that's why she's saying that they should pass the law so that they can legalize this irregular migrant, so they can work in the field, They can be paying taxes for them also. That's what she's saying. But the right-wing opposition, led by the legal leader, this Matteo, okay, he's strongly opposed to the idea and has called the proposal, that is the senatorial, he said he don't want it. He don't want it. He said he want to use illegal migrants to work in the field. But the woman say, let them put this senatorial, because the senatorial, 2012, when they pass the senatorial, people benefit from it. People have work. People, you know, go for the senatorial. They, you know, people who are, have been seeking for years so they can apply for medication. Some people, they benefit from it and the economy still grow. But now, how will the economy grow when they are using irregular migrants to work in the field? And she said it's against the law. So now the crops are dying, the crops are going down, and Italy is the second largest production of fruit and vegetables in Europe. So this year, if they don't take care, they will lose a lot of profits. That's why she's telling the parliament that they should pass this law so that they can use these migrants to work in the field, for them to produce, you know, the vegetables, the fruits. If not so, they will lose a lot of profits. That is a good idea. And that is our idea for this sanatorium. For those who work in the farm, and also for those who work in domestic sector. Because this domestic sector, some people do stay with the old people, some people do stay with children. Understand, if these people are irregular and they don't have documents, they can contact from this coronavirus and they can pass it to the citizens, they can pass it to other people. How will this coronavirus system, this crisis stop? Because they're irregular, they cannot access to doctor, they cannot go to hospital for checkup. So that's what she's saying, they should look for what she's saying and ideas for why she's bringing out this sanatorium. Understand? Many migrants are working. They pluck, you know, they pluck tomatoes, strawberries, grape. They pay them 3 euro for 1 hour. And they work 12 hours. Some they earn 30 euro a day, which is compared of double amount which legal person work. That's a person that work legally. The people that work legally, the amount these farmers they receive a day. People who work legally, they receive it. That is the double money. The double amount of money they receive a day. It's impossible, because they use these people to work. They use them to work, and these people work with their sweat, with their waste. They don't care. So this woman said, let us benefit by passing this law so that they can legalize these people, so that they can pay taxes, pay contribution. And now these people are working. Some people are working with contracts, paying taxes. But after the work finished, they don't have any benefits. Because if you are legal, when your contract finish, you can go for disoccupazione. So you can, you know, the government can pay you back the money you have paid for the contribution or the taxes. But now, because you're illegal, the money you lose everything. No benefits. So now they are crying, the farmers are crying, the organization are saying, let them pass this law. We need workers. The crops, this is harvest time. The harvest time is near. Now we need workers to work. Now there is shut down. Nobody can come in from the eastern part of Europe to come and work, because we need those people to come and work. So they want to use the irregular migrants to work, so they can pass the law, so they can give them a legit contract, so they can go assess for this sanatorium, so they can work. Because if they catch you using illegal migrants to work, they can find you, and you're going to pay big fund, a ticket. So this organization is saying, we don't want to pay tickets anymore. Pass this law so we can give them contracts, so they can be legal, and they can assess for doctors, they can assess for documents, so they can, you know, take care from themselves. So that's why the Minister of Agriculture, she's saying this. Understand? That's why she's saying this. If not so, the mafias will benefit by using these people to work in their farm system, all the money will be on them and they will pay them, you know, small money. Because if you are legal in a country, you have contracts, they will pay according to your contract. But when you don't have contracts, they will use you anyhow. And this is against the humanity. It's against the humanity. That's why she said, let us pass this law. Let us pass this law. Understand? Listen what she said. They called her, she said something.
Noi oggi il primo problema che abbiamo è quello di reperire la manodopera. Ci mancano, cosa sulla quale condividono le associazioni, tutte le associazioni agricole, ci mancano tra i 270.000 e i 350.000 lavoratori e lavoratrici per le prossime campagne di raccolta. Quello che noi non possiamo permettere è che un litro di latte o un chilo di frutta o di ortaggi venga distrutto perché non abbiamo trovato le persone per andare a farsi carico della raccolta di questi prodotti. Io sono concentrata su questo e su questo assumo anche la responsabilità di dire che se non siamo in grado di reperire persone che vanno a lavorare, noi dobbiamo farci carico di dare un'opportunità di lavorare in modo regolare e non attraverso lo schiavismo dei caporali anche ai cittadini immigrati che sono bloccati nei ghetti e che negli anni passati hanno lavorato in agricoltura in nero.
You hear what she talk? He said now they need to pass this law. They need 270 or 350,000 migrants to work in the field, and she don't want them to work illegally. She wanted to work legally in the farm. They should pass the law putting these sanatoriums so they can assess for this sanatorium so they can work legally, so they can be paying taxes, also paying contribution. And if they didn't pass this law, if she find that people are using the irregular migrant to work in that field, that she's going to sue those people. And many of the crops and many of the production have been spoiled because they don't use people to work, because they don't find the right people to work, because they don't want to employ people, because they are afraid to pass the law. So many of the production have been damaged, loss of production. So they should pass the law. Because Italians is the second largest production of vegetable fruits in Europe. So this year, if they didn't pass the law, it's gonna be a collapse for them. So that's why she's telling the parliament to pass this law. You should pass the law so they can benefit by paying taxes. Those the irregular migrants can, you know, benefit by having documents. They can go for health insurance, they can go for health checkup if they have any sickness or virus with them, so they can care for them. Because if many of them are illegal, they are going with this virus, they will be seen infecting many people. So let's think about it. So my brother, my sister, we need to be prayerful. So let's back this sanatorial issue with prayers, and let's God answer our prayers. So my brother, my sisters, just connect to this channel. Please don't forget to subscribe, don't forget to like, don't forget to share, like and share. More updates will be coming in. So please wear your mask when going outside, but going outside when necessary. But stay indoors, very important. Wash your hands regularly, you know, apply your sanitized cream on your palms. So it's very important. I love you guys and stay blessed. More updates will be coming in. Let's be prayerful. Let's be prayerful. Bye for now, brothers and sisters. Thank you.